Hey everybody, it's Bobo the Vulture, and we are playing Art of Fighting, and let's just resume the game, why don't we? I lost. We're fighting Mr. Question, who is the mysterious, the mysterious, nefarious man that, as far as I can tell, he's in charge of a karate gym. He's been the karate gym. Aw, you tried to put a picture of, a gallery of a mosque or something. Oh, fuck you and your Zanratsuken. Zanratsuken never works. Alright, block damage. Block damage does a lot more damage in this game than in other fighting games you may be familiar with. Which, to a certain extent, is fair. Somebody's throwing a ball of fire. Tell I'm getting all sailor mouthed. This is not a fun experience. Did you see that, everyone? He just pulled off a flawless Zanratsuken at the same moment I did to block it. Which is the only other time I've attempted to use, not Zanratsuken, the Haoshokoken. He did it the same time I did, and he did the other time that he did. And then he immediately threw another one, so at least you got to see how much damage it does when it connects. Oh, I was blocking, so it only did a little bit of damage. It only slightly devastated me. Now this guy looks a lot like my character, but I swear he has, well, okay. I got hit with the Haoshokoken. There's no coming back. Also, this stuff was really advanced and amazing looking for the time, but is it just me, or is it looking back at this? It seems like it didn't date quite as well as some of the other fighting games at the time. Like the sort of the animation and the sliding and the scaling back and forth is just a little sort of clicky. That is an architectural arcade. I gotcha. Press triangle and X together for a low kick and knock him down. That didn't knock him down. I Oh, there's an appearance of an old friend. And he can tell, right now. I'm dying, Bull. Is there anything you haven't yet described in the world of King of Chicago? I don't even know. Oh, fuck you. I almost had you. Feel like this is the trick. Gotta confuse him. Gotta confuse him by jumping over him. The same kind of bullshit cheating M. Bison uses when he does his stomp technique. Well, I'm dizzy. That's the end of this battle. Pretty much. You don't really have a chance to, Yeah, just walk straight towards you. Get this double perfect loss over with. Steers JG is using the phrase Mulkoken to describe what we originally heard the phrase Hao Shokoken as sounding like. Yeah, you'll notice I attempt to go for a Hauken at the same time as he throws one, and it comes out, just comes out. And his flies across the screen and hits me before I'm actually finished even releasing a fireball. The beautiful people. Yeah, let's press that button continually for, Sit down. Shut up.
Round two, fight.
So, skipping forward sometimes works, sometimes does not, because, oh, fuck. Because sometimes that happens instead. Let's lose perfect. Well, damn. It's very close there. I couldn't really do anything about his Mulkoken. Because, what Damn, Zomlax, you can. He has... Throwing doesn't work very well in this game, but you get up very close to them, press away, and the special button, that appears to be your best chance to throw. If you press double forwards, you could do a little leap forwards, but if they press double backwards, they'll do a little leap backwards. Jump towards enemy's back, press triangle button for flying back kick. Well, okay. Oh, good. I jumped into the air and then sort of just fell on that thing that wasn't even there. Halfway across the goddamn world. I got hit with his MX. He used half his gauge, and I wonder if he used half his gauge and doesn't have enough for the big one. If you use it, he won't be able to counter it. He'll still block it. But you'll also notice that he gets his strength back too quickly for that to really ever be an issue. Now, I understand what he's saying. If I was somehow able to taunt him into using the Haoshokoken twice, or like three times, because he has an extra large meter, so he could do it a bunch of times. When I say he has an extra large meter, if I finished the bottle cut game properly, I could have the same size spirit meter. Only a certain number of combinations of things that you can do, and he appears to have a scenario for all of them. We're off to the mysterious Mr. Question, and we're just gonna fight him all goddamn night. And he's the final boss, so it's not like, future. Oh, I understand, guys. Final round, fight. This is the thing I don't like about fighting games. Oh, come on, get... throw him! God damn it! Fuck! Fuck!
Round one, fight.
You didn't miss anything, Zerf. Didn't miss anything.
Round two, fight.
Why can't I throw him when he's stands there dizzy in front of me. And I can do it there. Do you have to jump behind a person to throw them? I don't think you do. Starcaster, if I didn't have unlimited continues, I would not be trying this at all. Oh, good. We're gonna get started on this pattern. Yeah, I've been thrown from the front. I've probably been thrown from every direction conceivable. Doing more damage than me. Now, I guess it wouldn't be the most objectionable thing in the world if you were, because I've only gotten as far as I have because the difficulty is set low, which probably means I'm doing more damage relative to my opponents than I'm meant to. Yes, Starcaster 5, that is what is called a Tengu mask. I will allow someone in the chat to explain what a Tengu mask is. Basically, they're a type of sort of demonic figure in Japanese culture. Oh, well, great. Why do I even bother trying? He has an ugly face, but he makes up for it with those biceps. Check him. Getting tired, angry, disappointed, all those things, yes. Because goddamn Zenratz Ken works for him as a counter to, like, leaping in. Or me just standing there. It works as a universal move. That was just silly. Oh, okay, fine, just hop in and such. Attempted to do it there, it was too late. You know what, if he keeps falling for Zenratz Ken at the beginning of the battle, I will start There. Okay. I won. Let's get a pathetic bonus. Oh no, we're exchanging Zenrot's gens. And I was blocking. Oh fuck, this isn't gonna work now, is it? Very close. Very close. I lost. Leap into Zanrat's Ken. Come on in, buddy. Nope. Nope, I'm busy. Oh, that's just insult to more insult. You didn't even need to use Zanrat's Ken to take me out. It does not always dizzy him. That time it certainly did. Oh boy. Well, that was 2-0. Let's continue, shall we? Oh, there we go. Attempted to catch him on a dizzy there. He did not deliver the goods. You're right, it does dizzy him sometimes, though. There's no real reliable way to work out dizzying in this. Wow. Just wow. Yeah. I've spent a full video worth plus at this point of just fighting Mr. Question. Shit! I was just trying for basic fireballs and it was not working. A problem that you can have here is that, and it works, it cuts both ways. Wait, you can kick me in the face out of Zanrat's Ken? But, since pretty much every move in this game, it seems like, does some amount of damage, blocked or no, if all they need to do is hit you a little bit, they can just be like, wow, I just punched a goddamn fireball out of the air. Tried to trip. He can be jumping in the air and land while I'm tripping and still get off a kick before I can. I lost rounds on hot sets. I'm positioned to win. You can be positioned to win for like an hour. That's right. I used it to counter your fireball and your leap in. Sunruts Ken cares not for your fireballs. Now I say that and he's gonna do a Shokoken to it sometime. Oh, he managed to throw two fireballs and hit me with enough blocked damage from them because he could throw them fast enough that took off like maybe a quarter of my life. That's what I get for not starting a fight with Zanratsuken. Just for that, I'm gonna leap in with Zanratsuken. Alright. Hey, for once I'm up on it. Rounds 1-0. Look at that, Ryo. Look at you doing all good. Oh no, he's taunted away my ability to use another Zanratsuken. Okay, he's probably got this round. I'm not going to save states at this point. Because I thought it might be close enough, but no, pretty much not. I guess when your bar is gone, it's too late. Yeah, I did an elaborate flipping kick there instead of throwing. What's that all about? Come on over here, why don't you? He just got up from the ground in mid-Zanratsuken. You should apologize to safe states in hell. I don't necessarily have a huge objection to safe states the world over, but if I've gotten this far... Fucking hell! Not throwing my controller around, because that doesn't do very much. There it goes again. Yeah, just throw endless fireballs, why don't you? Doesn't matter what I do in response to fireballs, you have enough spirit energy that you can continually throw them until my life bar is depleted from block damage. So I guess the fact that he's not doing that is a mercy. Let's just get cracked on the dad face, why don't we? Fireball to the face, how nice. I thought about going in it. He gave that one a lot of thought and then decided against it. It's not what I meant to do, but well, we can't win now. When you have that low of a life, you can't actually win, because he will do some move that causes block damage before you can reach him.
Round one, fight.
You can hit double tap forward to leap towards your guy, or double back to try and evade a guy, which is helpful if you're trying to move in for a throw, but of course you can be hit out of any of those, so... I mean, yes, Zerf, you can still technically just win it, but it would essentially require him to stop playing. Like here, he will throw a move, any kind of move. It can be a regular punch, and you do block damage. Regular punches do block damage in this game. So, unless he falls asleep at the wheel, of course then he does one that doesn't do block damage. I don't friggin' understand how half of this works. Yeah. Also, the continuous Ryo vomiting noises are not great either. Oh good, I got the other Zunrut's Ken off just enough to deplete my life meter, but not to actually even be seen. Yeah, just punch, why not you? Punch straight ahead. Well, this video will probably have to be split, or maybe I won't bother splitting it and just tell people, hey, scrub to the end. You know how YouTube scrubbing goes. I certainly do. Watch me be a YouTube scrub. Oh good, I just got all my spirit energy, but not all of it. Much of it taunted away. Hello, Hazel. You're sleeping very cute against my leg. Come on, you can't resist those fists in your face. He can throw them so quickly, there's nothing that I can do. I might as well just die at the hands of Zunrut's Ken. Strike square, then strike triangle, land a hard blow. It never works. Oh, and wow, I posed for so long afterward. I stand and pose after I do Zone Red Skin. By the way, I am at least appreciative enough that I've added to the vocabulary of people in the world that I know that are familiar with the phrase Zanratsuken by, like, huge multiples, just by playing this game and streaming it right now. So many people now know of... I mean, you guys are looking at it and seeing how ridiculously stupid it looks, right? We're all in agreement on that. And then it has this awesome, epic sound at the end of it. Yes, the Zanratsuken that goes... Yes! Well, that was very close, wasn't it? That wasn't even the Zanratsuken cheer. I've been hit, what, twice? No, just once that round. It only takes 3 hits from this guy. Point earlier was going to be proven, but then it wasn't. I don't even remember what point you're talking about. Was it the point about the Shokoken? Oh, it was the point about being block damage. Yeah. Oh, you beat me with a kick to the shin? So is it just extra insulting when he doesn't even bother going in to do a throw or a move or anything and just stands there and watches you be dizzy? Round one, fight. There. I've turned into quiet. One in Zanratsuken is fine. Well, that didn't work. Damn it, win. Yes. Indeed. Final round fight. This is the final fight. It's Street Fighter 2010. Hey, I was blocking high. Honestly, the zoom in, zoom out, as tight as they try and do the zooms, is more distracting than it is anything else. I don't know if anybody else is feeling that. But, like, it gets hard to keep track of where he is in the air. rising up to the challenge of Bobo's. It's stirring themes. Trip you a bunch, sure. No, it really does hurt when you hit your shin. I get that. A shin kick should be effective, but it just seems like it's a mean-spirited way to defeat your kung fu opponent. Sure. Just dive away into another dimension and dive back in immediately for the kick. It's all within the rules, Mr. Question. Oh, I see. So you're not dizzy after all that. Because I tried to block high because I thought he was probably going to go for a jumping in kick. Much like that sort of thing. God damn it! I attempted Zanratsuken. That was an interesting kick that I kept getting as I was attempting Zanratsuken. It worked. I guess I won't complain. I lost. I thought it was fairly exciting anyway. Just gonna throw my little fists around. Look at you there, the little fists. Hey, let me get some special bonuses for a flawless victory. Nope, none. Alright. Getting busy. There. Just trip. Just keep tripping. No, JG. Zanratsuken is too risky. too risky when there's only that little life at stake. Hey, we destroyed it. We destroyed the dojo. Stop it, Brielle!
Yuri, are you okay? I've been worried about you.
Whoa. Robert has a voice.
Yeah, I'm alright. Listen to me, Ryo. That man is our...
To be continued?
Producer, E. Kawasaki. Director, Finish Hishori. Programmer, John Gusso. Cross Moon DSK. Yeah, it's a lame end. What indeed. Is it because I played on the lowest difficulty? That why?
Overlord Darkwolf, that man is our mother. I can't operate on Mr. Question.
Hello, Overlord Darkwolf. You just missed out on this thing. Why did I just cut my dick off? Yeah. So Ryo Sakazaki goes to find his kidnapped sister. So he rescued his sister. His sister said, "That man is R." And then trailed off. I wonder what he could have been there to what she was about to say. I think if you play the highest difficulty, Yuri and Robert go to town. Whoa, Robert Garcia totally passed the training there. Well, there you have it, folks. I'm not doing a damn bit more of playing anything tonight, but you can take a look at Robert Garcia here in the demo mode. It's funny the kidnapper wasted time using this Sharpie to crack her out in the picture. Yeah, it is kind of weird. It is definitely time for go to bed. Holy crap. Those are nice stylish white designer pants Robert Garcia has. Everyone, this is the Neo Geo. This has been Let's Play Art of Fighting. That was an ordeal. Thanks, everyone.